Have you ever tried to customize your HTML list elements? Let's change this ugly HTML list into something beautiful with few lines of code. In this video, I'll show you 5 different approaches that you may take to customize your HTML list elements, and also we'll provide light as well as dark theme for our design. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. Let's create index.html file. Inside that, if I type exclamation sign and hit that tab button, then you'll get this HTML5 boilerplate. Now let's change title. For the title, I'm giving custom CSS gradient counter list, or you can call it custom list UI design. Now within the body tag, let's create ordered list. Within that, I'm creating list item, and again inside that list item, let's create paragraph tag. I'm writing what is game changer. You can select this code and duplicate it. And now within that paragraph tag, if I write lorem 10, if I hit tab button, you'll get this dummy text. This is what you call Emmet abbreviation. So if you don't have any idea about this Emmet abbreviation, then I have already created a separate video on that topic. You can check out. Once again, let's duplicate this code. I'm gonna change the paragraph. Let's write becoming best version of yourself. For now, I'm just creating 3 list items. Now with the help of live server extension, let's check out this result in our browser. As you can see, we have created 3 list items. Now we need to give our custom styles. For that, let's create a style.css file. Just below the title tag, let's give the link for our style.css file. Now within the style.css file, let's create root pseudo class. Within that, I'm creating primary CSS variable, and let's give this dark blue color. Similarly, I'm creating another text CSS variable, and I'm giving this light gray color. In order to prevent browser default margin and padding, for the universal selector, I'm giving margin and padding of 0. Similarly, for the box sizing, I'm giving border box, so that all the values related to padding, borders, that will be included within your width and height. Similarly, for the font family, I'm giving pop-ins if there is no internet connection. For that case, let's give sans serif. Now let's style this order list. For the order list, I'm giving maximum width of 25 rem. Similarly, for the body, let's give background color. I'm giving same primary CSS variable. Similarly, let's give display to flex. And if I give justify content to center, then you'll be able to bring this content horizontally center. Now let's style different list items. For the list item, I'm giving color. Let's give text color to that CSS text variable. And for the padding top and bottom, I'm giving pointed trim. And for the left and right, 0. Similarly, I want to give line at the bottom. For that, you could use border bottom, but instead of that, I'm using this box shadow. For the X offset, I'm giving 0. For the Y offset, I'm giving 0.08 trim. And for the color, let's give this dark gray color. Now we can give our custom bullets for these list items. For that, for the list item, you can give marker pseudo element. And I'm giving content. Let's give the string 01. Did you see that? You can also give different emoji. What if I give this file emoji? In your browser, did you see that? For each list item, you will be able to give that file emoji. But the problem with this approach is that we are giving the same custom bullets for each list items. But if you want to give different custom bullets for each list item, you can give dataset attribute. I'm giving data icon. And within that, let's give this fire. And for the second list, let's paste the same attribute. Let's change that fire emoji to trophy. And for the third list, let's give this badge. Now you can copy that data icon attribute, and instead of this string, you can give their attribute function, and within that function, you can pass that data icon attribute. Now in your browser, did you see that? You will be able to give different custom bullets for different list items. But again, the problem with this approach is that
no, God, please, no, no!
If you go to this caniuse.com website, with the help of this website, you can check the browser's compatibility. So if you check this marker pseudo element, you can see almost all the older versions of browser, they are not supporting this pseudo element. So instead of this marker pseudo element, you can use before pseudo element. Why? Because if you look at the browser's compatibility, you can see only old version of Internet Explorer it doesn't support. Otherwise, almost all the versions of different browser, they do support this element. So now instead of that marker pseudo element, you can give their before pseudo element. And now you can see along with that emoji, you will be able to get that number. So for our order list, you can give list style to none. Similarly, let's bring our emoji as well as the text in the same line. For that, for our list item, you can give display to flex. And if I give align items to center, now you can see all the content are vertically centered. As you can see, there isn't any gap between our emoji icon and text. So for that, for our before pseudo element, let's give padding right. I'm giving 0.8 rem. Now, instead of giving these different emojis, you can give different numbers. So for that, I'm changing that data icon to data number. And for the value, let's give 01, 02, and 03. And also now we need to change that data icon to data number. Now let's change the font. For the font width, I'm giving bold. For the font size, let's give 3 rem. And for the font family, let's give same Poppins along with sans serif. Now it's looking much more better. Similarly, you can use different images as well with the help of URL function. So instead of that attribute function, you can give URL. And for the value, you can give the link of any images that you want to use. And also, you can use directly another property called ListStyleImage. Now again, you can see there is another problem with this approach. The problem is that whenever you are adding new extra list item at a time, you need to give data number attribute manually, so it might affect in our productivity. So now you can remove this data number attribute. I'm showing you different approach so that you will be able to learn different ways of creating your custom list items. Now in order to achieve same thing for our ordered list, you can give the counter reset, and for the value I'm giving number, and for our list item you can give their counter increment. And for the value, I'm giving the same counter value, that is number. So for our order list, I'm giving their counter reset so that if you are giving different counter property for different list item, then it will help you to reset that counter. And whenever you are adding extra new list item, at that time we need to increase our counter value. For that, I'm giving their counter increment. So now we need to display this counter value. For that, for the before pseudo element, you can see I have given their content property. And now instead of that attribute function, you can give their counter. And instead of that data number, let's pass that counter value, which is number. In your browser now you can see you'll be able to get different number based on total number of your list items. And now within that counter function you can give the second parameter, our default value, that is decimal. What if I give decimal leading 0? In your browser you can see each number that starts with 0. You can also give other different list style type as well. What if I give upper roman? And also you can give unordered list style type. But if you are giving same custom bullets for different list items, then it doesn't make any sense of using this counter function. So let's take it back to decimal leading 0. Now I want to give the gradient color text. For that, let's give background. I'm giving linear gradient. For the angle, I'm giving 2 top. For the first color, let's give lime green. For the second color, I'm giving crimson. Now you can see you'll be able to get that background graded color. Now you can play with different values. You can give something like border radius of 50%. You'll be able to give this different shape. I just want to give gradient color text. So in order to achieve that, first of all, for the text color, let's give transparent. And I'm giving background clip property. It is new property, so it may not be supported by all the old versions of browser. So let's give the prefix WebKit. For the background clip, I'm giving text. Now you can see you will be able to get that gradient color text. Instead of giving this gradient color for each number, I want to give this gradient color for whole list. So in order to achieve that, there is another trick. What if I give background attachment to fix? Did you see that? Now you will be able to get that beautiful gradient color text or numbers. Let's increase our list items. You can select this whole code and duplicate it. If you didn't like that gradient color, you can change that lime green to cyan. Or you can give your own favorite gradient colors, that is up to you. Now let's give some extra little bit of animation. For that, let's copy that list item and paste it down there. Now when you hover list item at the time, you can duplicate this box shadow and bring it down there. Let's change that color to white color. Now you can see when you take your mouse near to that list item, you will be able to get that brighter version of lines. But you can see we are not getting that smooth animation or transition. So for that, for list item, you can give transition. I'm giving transition duration to 0.3 seconds. So now you can see you'll be able to get that smooth transition. Similarly, I want to give separate style for this paragraph tag as well. So for the paragraph tag, let's give the position of relative. For the left, I'm giving minus 3 rem. Again, let's duplicate that transition code and bring it to that paragraph. Again, you can duplicate the paragraph code and bring it down there. Now when you hover that list item at the time for the paragraph, let's change that left value. So you can duplicate that code and bring it down there. For the left, let's change it to 0. So in your browser, you can see when you take your mouse near to that list item, you will be able to get this beautiful animation. Similarly, I want to give the animation for our before pseudo element as well. So for that, once again, you can duplicate that transition code and bring it down there. And also let's duplicate that before pseudo element and bring it down there. Now, when you hover that list item, before that, let's give the initial opacity value to 0.1. And also let's change that transition duration to 0.5 seconds. Now you can barely see that numbers. Now you can duplicate that opacity and bring it to that hover section. Let's change that opacity to 1. In your browser, did you see that? Now you'll be able to get that beautiful animation. Now you can see our custom list items. They are okay, but you can be more creative with this design on something like you can give different styles, different shapes, and also you can create different cards and use it there. It depends upon your creativity. So I think our design can be improved. For that, let's create another CSS variable secondary, and I'm giving more darker version of blue color. And for our list item, you can give linear background color. So for the background, let's give linear gradient. For the angle, I'm giving 40 degree. For the first color, I'm giving that same secondary CSS variable. And for the second color, let's give transparent. And also let's change that padding left and right value to 1 rem. And also let's give some space between our list items. For that, I'm giving margin top and bottom to 1 rem. For the left and right, 0. And now you can comment out that box shadows. At the time, when you hover list item, let's give filter brightness, I'm giving 85%. So now you can see when you hover, you will get a bit darker version of that list item. And also for our list item, let's give some rounded corners. For that, let's give border radius of 0.8 rem. By pressing F11 key, let's take our browser to the full screen. I think now it's looking much more better. What do you think? And also if you don't want to give that animation for our paragraph, then you can comment out this code. And also you know this is the dark theme. So what if I change it to light theme? So for that, let's change CSS variable's color value. For secondary, let's give white. And for the primary, let's change it to light gray color. And for the text, let's give this dark gray color. I think for the primary variable, let's give a bit darker version of gray color. Now in your browser, you can see this is the light theme. And if you want that animation for our paragraph, you can uncomment that code. But I think that animation is pretty cool. Now let's change it back to dark theme. And in our dark theme, it is looking pretty cool as well. So let me know in the comment box, did you love the dark theme or the light theme? So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already ate, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn. So keep learning.